Ciao, salve, come va?
Salve, ciao.
Tutto ok?
Tutto ok.
Prego.
Persone
grazie, ti ho fatto
un giro. Sì, no,
ah, wow, che bello.
Sono te cosa scusa per me. Persone.
Come va?
Complimenti per questo bellissimissimo studio.
Ah, questo, però l'edificio è stato fatto da italiani dall'epoca, seconda guerra mondiale. Così, non so che conosci questo architetto Benito Mussolini.
Ah, scherzo. È un architetto, sì, l'ho sentito
sì. Lui. Così tutto il centro è dell'epoca della seconda guerra mondiale. Poi sono arrivati i comunisti, però non ne hanno distrutti
questi edifici. Meno male, i comunisti hanno distrutto tutto.
Sì, come dice voi, Tirana è l'unica città in Europa dove puoi essere nel centro della piazza, ti fai un giro di 360 gradi e vedi tutti questi pezzi di storia.
Meraviglia.
La moschea ottomana, l'epoca fascista, poi i comunisti, poi questi edifici moderni. Così siamo felici qui. Stiamo andando.
State andando bene, vedi,
sì,
vero?
Alla grande.
Molto bene. Beh, no, ma è bello questo studio.
Qui, prima di Covid, ogni giorno avevamo visite dei bambini.
Beh,
di una classe.
Ma guarda, lo dico perché forse io sono ancora una bambina. Anzi, morirò bambina, ma entrando
un po' Peter Pan, no?
Sì, entrando hai la gioia, cioè c'è un'atmosfera di
energia, yeah. Sì, sì, sì.
Bellissimo.
So every day before COVID, one class, so we have
come
a list,
and
come and visit the mayor, they can ask anything. So we take everything, everybody sits on the floor, so we can't wait to recuperate. So it really feels like a playground, because
yes,
children can connect
yes
to an object.
Of course.
For the last 5 years, we worked very hard, because when you're a politician or when you're an elected official, you get trained and you get advice to only think of voters and taxpayers, which automatically excludes everybody under 18.
Yeah.
So it practically means that if you are not a voter and a taxpayer, you don't exist, politically speaking. So we started changing this a little bit. Then we started with these kids, you know, planting a tree for their birthday, and then with the bike lanes, and we do mandatory bike courses in the kindergartens, and then we started doing all these playgrounds, which was a big political fight. 5 years ago, it was a mess. All the right wing was fighting these playgrounds. They said, "Oh, the mayor wants to, he's doing children's stuff." And we said, "Look, if we don't start there, we have no future."
You're so
and
right.
The fact that we always
I'm gonna cry now, really, because it's so real. It's so beautiful.
But it's
yeah
what really works well, because these kids
will be,
then become advocates.
They will, yeah, but
the
they
city
will be the Albanians from tomorrow.
So it's fantastic. When we wanted to do this square completely car-free, huge protests
about
our cars in the center of the city. So then we started to have these car-free days for children. So kids wanted to get a bike because it was a car-free day. The city center was closed. And then their parents wanted to get a bike to follow the kids. And then, of course, some people were extremely pissed at me and, you know, giving me the finger and writing all horrible stuff in the social media. But wait, when kids would go home, they said, you know, a mother or father would say, "Oh, we're so pissed at the mayor, you know, he's a communist, wants to take our cars away." And then the kid would say, "But dad, you know, I had so much fun. This was the first time I got to ride my bike. And I had my balloon. And this was a time to play in the heart of the city." So they started becoming advocates. If you are an adult, you are very suspicious of politicians. It's normal. But you're not suspicious of your own children. So if the mayor says this is the right thing to do to keep a healthier city, to keep some parts of the city car-free, then they say, blah, 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 it's a politician. But if your child says this, you say, my kid had so much fun.
Yeah.
Maybe it's worth the wait or the ring road around the center so kids can play. So it's taken a while, but we're here now. And you are based in Italy, you're moving, where is home now?
Now it's in Italy.
In Italy.
I've been for a long time in Russia, but life, you know, boyfriends, so I came back to Italy right now.
Yeah.
And I think that I am more. So I'm a little girl walking in
yeah
an old body.
He said there's a beautiful office here.
No, it's good energy.
I never
it's
saw
good karma.
I never saw a mayor office where there's a bicycle.
No, me either.
I know. So sometimes kids come and run
like
with the bike.
A bed
of course,
here.
Of course, when you know
and
the story.
And the TV, and I sleep here.
Okay. And where are you from?
I'm in Germany, basically.
From Germany, yes.
close to in the Black Forest area.
Wohnst du in Schwarzwald?
Schwarzwald, ja.
No, it's beginning of the Schwarzwald.
Have you been here before in this country?
No, it's the first time.
So we have a huge, you know, the big rivalries in Albania are between German fans and Italian fans in football. So it's almost a war here when because in Germany, of course, everybody's with Germany and Italy, but in Albania it's a very, very wild division between German fans and Italian fans. So for example, the Prime Minister is a big Italian fan, Edi Rama. He was the previous mayor here. And our head of parliament is a big German fan. So when
I don't like football.
I like to play. I don't like to
watch. Which is better.
I'm very impatient.
Okay.
So I have attention deficit disorder. I
cannot get me too.
So I'd like to be a player, not to sit and. But some people love watching and drinking. And,
like my father.
Yeah.
Like my son, he gets crazy. Sometimes I'm in my room and I hear, ah! And it's, you can be there, and go!
Yeah. Every time I go to visit him, I hate being there during the evening because he's always watching Germany, actually, Bayern.
So you're from Germany.
So
Bayern
München fan.
Yeah. Germany.
But it's, but again, like for arts and culture and for football, I mean, this pandemic will be in our memory for
forever.
Forever.
I wonder, well, now, you know, they do tampon every day. We do tampon. But they're still scared in Italy to produce, hopefully in January. Yeah. But if we don't produce, what will you watch?
Mm. You have to produce. And I think
we will watch old movies.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Let's you have some beautiful movies. I mean, you know, I remember probably from your first time here that people would watch you and your films illegally in this country.
Illegally?
During communism, yeah. I mean, during the 80s.
How strange, are you sure? Because in Russia, they could watch my movies.
Let me tell you. I was born in 79, and I remember the 80s. So when we were having food, and food here were it was rationed, so you had a coupon.
Yeah, I know.
You couldn't go to the supermarket. You just... extremely isolated country. It's like North Korea. But my parents would always save the sardine cans. And I was wondering, why don't we throw the sardine cans? And then in every neighborhood, we had a little technician. It was called Technico. TV technician. And it was a black market term for people who can produce amateur antennas to catch Rai. Rai 1, Rai 2, Rai 3. So I remember. See, ci dai film Gitt Fires di Paraisis? Con Francesco Nuti. Come si chiamava?
Tutta colpa
del paradiso. E questo è dell'anno.
Carolina era appena nata, 84, 85.
Così. L'Albania è stato ufficialmente aperta nel 91, 90-91. Così già all'epoca. So they had all this. You speak Italian or?
No,
I understand
that. Okay, so let's do it in English. So they keep these sardine cans, and these TV technicians would come, they put in a stick these aluminum parallel wires with this sardine can with a little screw. And these screws, there was these two plugs, I remember already, and it would be enough to connect to UHF waves from southern Italy. Sì, così tutti i tuoi film.
Ah, perché tu parli di Tutta colpa del paradiso, ma i film di Celentano li hanno fatti vedere ufficialmente qua. Yes.
Non so.
Nel
non
momento
so
dove,
che
sono, dove sono state aperte tutti i canali, sì, però
no.
Prima no.
Prima no.
No, prima no. Prima
è per
no.
Questo che il signore ti
ah,
ha detto
allora
che era...
con le sardine.
Sì.
Okay.
Prima credo che sia stato solo Totò o quelli film vecchi che...
Ma why? Because in Russia they did show during the communism. The movies of Celentano.
Perché
they were allowed.
Perché loro hanno andato su questo periodo che si chiamava perestroica, un po' di apertura.
Ah.
E qui il comunismo è stato durissimo. E l'Albania non è. Albania did not carry on with the Soviet with the Warsaw Pact because the dictator here thought they were becoming too liberal. So they said they were the imperialists from the West, and the revisionists from the East, meaning left Soviet Union, liberalizing to copy the West. So he was really the North Korea of Europe.
Oh.
So they were watching your films with sardine cans and aluminum wires and all this black market. So when, sì, quanto il sole tramontava, so when the sun would go down, everybody would open their windows and they put these antennas. And you know, one would be in the kitchen and says, no, no, turn it a bit until they would get the... He was hysterical. So when communism collapsed in 91, everybody spoke fluent Italian.
Yeah.
So they couldn't realize how the most isolated country in the world, everybody spoke a fluent second language. Oh, un piccolo regalo per te.
Sono, complimenti, avete un sindaco bellissimo.
No, ci proviamo, proviamo.
Beh, sei un bellissimo, che ci puoi fare?
Questo è l'orologio di Tirana. Te lo regalo perché è il chilometro zero di tutta l'Albania. Così tutte le distanze si misurano dall'orologio di Tirana. E credo che il regalo più prezioso che uno può dare è il tempo. Quello tempo che abbiamo passato, il tempo che fanno l'amicizia, il tempo di crescere insieme. È anche una memoria del mio tempo come un bambino, quando abbiamo fatto tutte queste avventure con le antenne, con le scatole di sardine per vederti nei tuoi film. Così ti ringrazio per la mia infanzia e per tutte le belle memorie.
Grazie, adesso grazie. Mi commuovi, grazie. Grazie, adesso detto, tu sei senza io, tamponata. È tutto. Io ho degli amici albanesi, mi hanno detto, vedrai, è una persona speciale e penso che davvero lo sei. E mi fa molto piacere incontrare un sindaco così pieno di idee meravigliose, ce ne sarebbe bisogno in tutto il mondo. Il cambiamento dall'altra volta a questo, io sono stata pochissimo l'altra volta. Sono arrivata, ho fatto di corsa la cosa, ma c'è un grande cambiamento. Mi sembra che sia in grande crescita l'Albania e mi sembra una cosa meravigliosa. Ve lo meritate.
Grazie,
ve lo meritate perché tanto tempo, con tante brutte cose, ve lo meritate.
Grazie.
Grazie a voi.
Grazie mille.